Hi, my name is Farwa Adik and welcome back to Interactive Horror Stories. It's time for After Funeral, so let's go. After Funeral is a modern gothic horror story that takes place 3 days after your son's burial. Ooh. You receive messages in your computer. Those claim to be sent by your son's soul. He says that he wants to be with you once again. And he asks you to do a few things in order to be resurrected. Will you believe this message? Sure. You used to be a father. It has been 3 days since your son, Jonathan White, was buried in the graveyard of the local church. He was 8 years old. He had a golden hair and blue eyes. Just like the beloved man in the carpenter's song, close to you. Since your wife passed away giving birth to Jonathan, and since he has been your everything. He was your angel, and now he's gone. He died in a snowy winter morning. You had gone to the market, leaving him alone at home. When you arrived at home, you found Jonathan lying on the bed motionless. His face was covered with his pillow. Choked. Police couldn't find any trace of trespassing. You clearly remember the solemn moments of Jonathan's funeral. In fact, you tried to forget. But the details are in front of your eyes and they won't go away. The priest had intoned psalms and prayers, those you are not so familiar with, you are not so religious. With the lifeless body of your son laid in the church, his feet were turned to the east. He was wearing black suits and shiny shoes. His skin was pale. He was way too young for all of this. You wished it was you lying there instead of him. I can get that. That's sad. Like the day Jonathan died, it's snowy day in all of Ohio. There are 3 inches of snow outside. It's 2 a.m. now. A.m.? P.m.? I don't know. I don't care. You are a writer who has been on writer's block since that day. Your favorite word processor is open in the computer. The screen is blank. You haven't written anything for a long time. There are cigarette butts in the ashtray and your black hot coffee in a blue cup on your work table. You chain smoke and consume a lot of coffee nowadays. Jesus. This is really loud. Jesus Christ. As you're sipping your coffee, the doorbell rings. Let's open the door. You open the door. It's Bob, your neighbor and friend. You had drunk beers and had barbecue with him for several times. Bob is a nice guy. He is overweight, has short black hair, and has no facial hair. He wears a dark blue jacket and black beanie. Hey, how are you? I wanted to ask how you have been. I'm fine. Bob believes in your lie. It is good that you are doing better, fam. Everyone knowing losing your kid is a hard process, but I am sure you will get over it. You are a strong man. Bob continues. I am going to the market right now. Do you need anything? You remember that you are out of cigarettes. Well, let's just ask him. Ah, you need cigarettes. He puts his hand in his pocket, then pulls a pack of cigarettes. Maybe I am a bad friend for doing this, but anyway, take this. I will buy myself another pack in the market. You take the pack that has 10 cigarettes inside and thank him. Oh, that's so sweet. Okay, man, see you later. You say goodbye to Bob too. Then he goes. You close the door and sit back on your work table. You look at the computer screen. That should have been blank. But no, it is not blank. Something is written. Daddy? I missed you. Ooh. Type Jonathan? You type Jonathan at the computer? Then new letters get appended at the text in the screen. Whoever types it, he, she, it writes fast. When they are finished, they form 2 sentences. I can hear you, Daddy. Talk to me. Just shout. After you shout to see your deceased son's name out, new letters appear and form a reply. Yes, it is me. You're not a computer engineer, but you know that it is possible to hack someone's computer and put a prank on him. If the computer is online, your computer is connected to the internet with an Ethernet cable. Pull it out. You crouch down and frantically pull the Ethernet cable from your computer. You expect that nothing else will be written, but no. You're wrong. I am in the computer. How is that possible? Good Lord said that I should be together with you. He said that I love you and you love me, so he sent me back.
Oh?
I am so afraid, Daddy. It is cold and dark. I am so cold here. Please bring me back. Do you want to see me once again?
I don't know how.
How am I gonna see you again? Like in the spirit form or... Sure.
Find 5 candles and wait for the midnight. Bye for now, Daddy. You have got only 1 candle at home. You normally use the candle when the electricity is gone, so you didn't need more than 1 candle before. What will you do?
Buy them for the market.
So you wear your long beige coat and black leather boots and walk to the market to buy 4 candles. Then you return home. At home, you wait in front of your monitor. Nothing happens until midnight. Then a new message appears on the screen. I am back, Daddy. Did you bring me the candles?
Sure.
Good. Let me explain how you can bring me back. Go to the cemetery. Dig my grave. Bring my coffin home.
Hold on. I'm a grave digger. What? Okay.
We shall speak again once you bring my coffin. You know it is insane what you do, but you get prepared to go get outside. You wear your coat and get outside your home. It is snowing like hell. A cold interpretation of hell. Outside, the sky has a bright purple color, illuminating the night with the help of a full moon behind the clouds. You get in your car and start it. The streets and roads are empty. There is only you outside in this hour of night. It doesn't take long to arrive to church and its graveyard. Graveyard is covered with snow and grey mist. No lights come from the church. Either there is nobody inside or the priest is sleeping. That's good. You can't be seen while digging your son's grave. You find the graves of your son and wife. Jonathan White was buried next to his mother. There is an unoccupied area next to them. You will be buried there when your time comes. You search for a shovel. You find it in about 10 minutes. You are ready to dig the grave. You start digging Jonathan's grave. After 6 feet of digging, you reach a little wooden coffin. You climb down. Then carry the coffin up. After that, you climb up and carry the dirty coffin to your car's backseat. You had never done something this bizarre before. After you reach home, you get off your car and carry the coffin home. Luckily, there is nobody around. You drag the coffin to your living room center. You don't care about the floor getting dirty with soil. Thank you, Daddy, gets written on the screen. Now put the candles around my coffin, like a star.
Okay.
You carefully place the candles around the coffin, making it the center of a star. You light them with your lighter. Now read these aloud, Daddy.
A lonely goat on a mountain. He's thirsty. Thirsty for humanly love and affection. I shall give them the water.
You read the lines. A lonely goat. Oh.
I already read that. Screw you.
And the coffin starts to shake. The coffin lids up, open slowly. You see Jonathan opening the lid and raising up. His skin is pale, almost white. You can smell the rot of his undead corpse. He is wearing that black suit you couldn't forget. He stands on his feet and smiles at you. Then he steps outside the coffin, away from you, without saying anything. And he does something you wouldn't expect from the dead. He dances. He dances with joy. After half a minute, he stops dancing, stares at you. His eyes are still blue.
Take me in your arms, Daddy. Take me to the bathroom. I want to show you something.
It is impossible not to obey what he says. You feel his presence dominating the room, overwhelming you, and it's impossible to say no. You crouch down and take him in your arms. You carry him to the bathroom. You bring him to the dark bathroom. You turn on the light and get horrified by what you see in the mirror. The boy's reflection is different. His skin is burnt, like coal. Jonathan had an innocent and handsome face, but the face you see is so far from being pleasant. It is like a really old man's face, who is also very ugly, and he has no hair.
I always wanted a daddy like you, says the eldritch abomination you hold in your arms.
The end.
And also, there are two possible endings. Holy shit. These things are getting creepy. I got chills on me, man. Jesus. I'm gonna leave it right here. So, thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Watch the info cards to watch more videos that I have done. And I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.